गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, आई दिनेश प्रताप सिंह, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर ईसी, ओरिएंटल इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ साइंस एंड टेक्नोलॉजी, वेलकम यू ऑल। टुडेज टॉपिक इज पीआर रिडक्शन इन ओएफटीएम, पीक एवरेज टू पावर रेशियो, दैट इज डिसएडवांटेज ऑफ ओएफटीएम टेक्निक। सो आई विल स्टडी हाउ टू रिड्यूस PAPR in OFDM, orthogonal frequency division multiplexing। Introduction। Due to many application of OFDM signal in army, military, HF radio links, digital audio broadcasting, digital video broadcasting, and there was need to change from analog domain data sending to digital domain data sending, also changing of single carrier to multiple subcarriers. In OFDM, the transmission of data is doing by multiple subcarriers data transmission. OFDM plays tremendous advantages, including channel conversion due to its orthogonality of the subcarriers, special efficiency and robustness against inter-symbol interference and inter-carrier interference. The main disadvantage, or worst disadvantage of OFDM, is high peak to average power ratio at the transmitter, which reduces the peak power for transmission. Several techniques to reduce high PAPR are clipping and filtering, selective mapping method, partial transmit sequence compounding, and tone injection have been proposed. Today I will discuss two effective methods for multi efficiency PAPR reduction, known as SLM, selective mapping, and clipping and filtering, to reduce high PAPR. Peak to average power ratio for OFDM signal. The main drawback is high peak to average power ratio. High PAPR is significantly caused due to IFFT operation, where data symbols across subcarrier add up to produce high peak power value. This causes signal amplifiers to operate into non-linear region, leading to distortion. In-band distortion degrades system performances, and out-of-band radiation causes the adjacent channel interference due to neighbor band effect and degradation of bit rate error or bit error rate performance. The peak to average power ratio of continuous time signal is given by formula PAPR is equal to peak power of the signal upon peak average power of the signal, that is equals to maximum of amplitude or modulation of xt square upon ext x square. And for the discrete time signal, PAPR is equal to maximum xnr n whole square upon exn modulus whole square. कंटिन्यूस टाइम सिग्नल के लिए मैक्सिमम ऑफ एक्स टी होल स्क्वायर, दैट इज एम्पलीट्यूड अपॉन एनर्जी पी ई एक्स टी स्क्वायर, एंड फॉर डिस्क्रीट सिग्नल पी ए पी आर इज इक्वल टू मैक्सिमम ऑफ एक्स एन स्क्वायर अपॉन ई एक्स एन स्क्वायर, where P peak denotes peak value, P average means average output power, E denotes the expected value, Xn denotes the transmitted OFDM signals. If the number of subcarriers capital N is increased, the PAPR power also increases. Large Xn are zero mean Gaussian random variables, and for Xn complex Gaussian, the OFDM signal is rarely distributed with variance sigma n square, and the phase of the signal is uniform. Phase of PAPR maximum is equal to 1 minus phase of PAPR maximum in bracket PAPR naught ki power whole n, where capital N is number of subcarriers. The fixation of threshold value ranges from 0 to maximum value. To calculate the threshold value, the equation below is used. For threshold value, this equation is used, that is, threshold is equal to PAPR maximum minus PAPR minimum upon PAPR maximum into PAPR minimum. Threshold value is updated regularly and CCDF curve is drawn. To PAPR reduction techniques, there are two methods for reducing PAPR. One is amplitude clipping and filtering, another B, selective mapping technique. Distortion method includes clipping and compounding, whereas distortion layers methods also include clipping and filtering, selective mapping, partial transmit sequence, tone injection, etc. We mainly discuss two types of typical techniques, such as selective mapping and amplitude clipping and filtering for PAPR reduction in OFDM systems. Amplitude clipping and filtering process. By this technique, amplitude is clipping, one of the simplest reduction techniques for PAPR. Amplitude clipping reduces the peak level of the input signal to a predetermined value. According to SHN and J.S. Lee, the basic idea of this technique is to clip the parts of the signals that have higher peak outside of the allowed region. हम इस टेक्निक में एक लेवल फिक्स कर देंगे कि इस पीक से ऊपर और इस पीक से नीचे के लेवल को कट ऑफ कर देंगे, केवल अलाउड रीजन ही पास करेंगे बैंड पास यूजिंग बैंड पास फिल्टर. तो आउटपुट इस तरह से हमें मिलेगा, yt is equal to माइनस एल इफ एक्स टी इज लेसर देन माइनस एल, एक्स टी इफ माइनस एल टू एल, एल इफ एक्स टी इज ग्रेटर देन एल, माइनस एल टू एल के बीच में क्लिपिंग लेवल रहेगा. इफ एक्स टी इज लेसर देन माइनस एल then minus L, if XT is greater than L then L, where YT is pass band clipped signal, L is pre-specified clipping level and XT is pass band signal. So, by this equation we understand the clipping process, clipping and filtering process. This is the block diagram of clipping and filtering process. जो इसमें input signal होता है उसको QPS के modulation scheme से pass करते हैं, quadrature phase shift की, फिर signal IFFT modulation होता है, inverse fast frequency transform, उसके बाद clipping, amplitude clipping process and filtering process using band pass filter, and then it goes to amplifier. After amplifier it's transmitted OFDM signal. Clipping is performed always at the transmitter. Receiver signal depends on the clip signal estimated. In general, since the receiver has to calculate two important parameters like location and size of the clipping signals at one clipping per OFDM symbol, clipping method may cause in band distortion or out of band radiation into the OFDM system, leading to peak regrowth, especially in non-linear system. The out of band signal cost can be reduced by filtering. However, when the signal is clipped at a certain level, at a definite level, some peak power reduces lower and filtering the clip signal can reduce out of band radiation. पैरामीटर्स यूज फॉर क्लिपिंग एंड फिल्टरिंग. पैरामीटर्स और उनकी वैल्यू इस टेबल में दी गई है. जैसे मॉड्यूलेशन, इसमें क्वाड्रेचर एम्पलीट्यूड मॉड्यूलेशन यूज़ किया गया, चैनल मॉडल, एडिटिव हाइट, गॉसियन नॉइस, AWGN, FFT साइज 256, 2 की पावर, दिस इज 2 की पावर 8 इज इक्वल टू 256, सब कैरियर्स 200, क्लिपिंग लेवल 0.79 एंड फेस सीक्वेंस 8. क्लिपिंग एंड फिल्टरिंग प्रोसेस में क्लिपिंग लेवल माइनस 0.79 टू प्लस 0.79 के बीच में फिक्स किया गया. फेस सीक्वेंसेस 8 हैं. FFT साइज 256 यूज़ किया गया. और सेकंड मेथड है PAPR रिडक्शन का, वो है SLM, सेलेक्टिव मैपिंग टेक्निक. दिस मेथड इज यूज्ड फॉर द रिडक्शन ऑफ पीक टू एवरेज ट्रांसमिट पावर ऑफ मल्टी कैरियर मॉड्यूलेशन सिस्टम विद सेलेक्टेड मैपिंग. इन सेलेक्टेड मैपिंग द होल सेट ऑफ इंफॉर्मेशन सिंबल आर लोडेड इनटू द सब कैरियर एंड टर्न इन सीरियल एंड पैरेलल एडर. द डेटा ब्लॉक आर फॉर्म एंड देन द मोस्ट फेवरेबल signal with less PAPR is chosen and transmitted. The basic idea of this technique is based on the phase rotation sequence. The lowest PAPR signals shall be selected for transmission from a number of different data blocks independently. This is the block diagram of selective mapping method, where input data source goes to partition into blocks and serial and parallel adder. Serial and parallel, after serial and parallel conversion, this goes to modulate BU, BE1 and BU. BU then passed to IDFT, inverse discrete Fourier transform section, and B also to IDFT section, and this pass on to P0, P1, PU. Considering select one minimum peak to average power ratio decision device, using decision device, we select one minimum PAPR. And this is the whole process. PAPR is greater than P0 is equal to 1 minus bracket in bracket 1 minus e की power minus P0 का whole की power n, where n is the subcarrier and u is the phase sequence. Parameters used for selective mapping. The parameters are modulation, QAM modulation used in selective mapping, channel models, AWGN model, number of subcarriers 256, and phase sequences used 8. We apply parameter in the equation 7 to determine the reduction amplitude peak power level and the threshold value using equation 5, where the lowest PAPR is experienced.
थैंक यू।